Disclaimer, I'm not a blogger. I simply video Otis and I's adventures around the UK and that of our animal family at home. I've had a lot of messages though about how I got Otis used to the paddle board, and there's always a lot of questions along those lines on Facebook, so I thought I'd put a little something together. Otis did find it tricky today, as she hasn't actually been on the board on dry land like this for a couple of years now. But she's a good girl, she's done everything I've asked. Some dogs may not need it. Some dogs may be so utterly confident that they get straight on and off you go. Brilliant! Because Otis coming on the paddle board was really quite important to me, it's what I enjoy when I'm away camping and travelling, I started from square one just to make sure we really got it right. If you're someone that doesn't mind their dog jumping in and off the board, that's not a problem. Whatever you want to do is up to you, as long as you're consistent with it, and then your dog understands what's wanted. My last bit of advice, probably best not to take the cats. Have fun paddling. I've come out here to start recording a bit about how to get your dog used to the paddleboard. The cat has no issue with it.
Several people have asked me how I got my dog onto the board. My last dog, my working collie, came out with me but wasn't keen. Whereas I knew that my next dog, I wanted to be a proper paddling dog. So, Otis started from very young, and I'm going to show you a few things that you can do to start with at home and then progress. Basically, break everything down. So, one of the noises that your dog might not have heard is the bump. Otis has heard it because we go camping, but it's in a different context. So, I'm going to let her just listen to that, really. I'm going to ask her to wait. Otis, sit. Yeah. I mean, she's not bothered about it. Oh, she'll get some sweeties ready, ready. Yeah. Good girl. Well done. Right, I'll finish pumping the board up. We'll move to the next stage. Okay, so board is pumped up, nowhere near full PSI, but I'm not going paddling, it's absolutely fine for what we're doing now. Otis is very toy motivated, she's quite food motivated, which is very helpful. All we want to get to start with is just confidence with being on and around board. So, I've got a treat, I'm going to chuck it over that side. Good girl. Well done. Good puppy. Good girl, Whiz. Good job. Well done. Good. 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 Well done, puppy. Okay. Good. Now she does know a two paws cue, so that was very useful. Good girl. Two paws. Wait. And off in the water with toy. Leave it. Now, next thing we want really, once they're confident on and off, is a place cue. Sit up. Good. Wait. My routine with my dogs is that they have a long walk before we go paddling. They don't get off the board while we're paddling. I've got a few reasons for that. I paddle in areas with lots of wonderful wildlife. The last thing I want is my dog getting in water, disturbing it, upsetting nests. I also paddle all year round. I don't want her getting cold. If she gets in near the beginning of the paddle, she's then wet and cold for the next 2 or 3 hours. Not very fair. It's also just very unstable. I sit when I paddle. I use it basically as a kayak, but an easily transportable one. But even so, a dog jumping off the board can be really quite unsettling, particularly on the sea and with waves around. So, Otis just having a drink, and we'll have a look at the place cue. I use clicker. She's been clicker trained from young. So when she's where I want her to be, She knows that by hearing for that click sound. She knows that means she gets a reward. She doesn't necessarily get it straight away. We don't get paid every minute of our day, but she will get paid eventually. So, ready, ready? On it. Good, and wait. Good. So that's about where I'm going to want her to be. At the moment, it is just the reward for being there. Good girl. Okay, puppy, puppy. Good girl. Well done. You ready, ready? Ready, ready? On it. Good. Oh, nice job. Nice job. Good girl. Good job. And off. Good. Well done. I'm going to leave her a bit longer this time. Ready? On it. And settle. Good. Nice settle. Good girl. I'm going to move around. So that wasn't good enough. No reward. Settle. Wait. Good girl. Wait. So she started to learn. This is your basic wait, but hopefully they've learned everywhere else. We're just now adding it to the board. Good girl, good settle. And as that was a bit longer, I'm going to reward her on the board. Settle. So I haven't released her yet. Good girl. And okay. So you want a word for on it, a word for settle or something similar. That means they're going to be there for a little while. And then a release word to say you can get off now. Good job, well done. She's pretty happy, pretty confident on it. Next step will be I will want some movement on the board. After all, that's what's going to happen. So, OT settle. Good, nice settle. Well done. Settle. Good girl. And I can stay by her head. So she's got reassurance. Good girl. And I'm just going to move it a little bit. A little tiny bit. Good girl, well done. Make some noise on it. And settle. Good girl. Well done, baby shark. Here we go. Starting to get some movement. Good girl. And settle. Well done. And again, do a bit of that. And then reward. Good girl. Good job. Well done. Well done. Good. Settle. Settle. Good girl. Nice settle. Good. Well done. Okay, good job. Well done. Good girl, baby shark. Good. Next strange thing is that when we're on the board, we're going to be sat or stood behind our dog. That's a really weird thing for them. We don't do it very often in life. So I'm going to look really ungainly and get down there. And then call her on the board with me, which again is my routine when I'm getting on the water. I'm quite unsteady. I want to get on board first, then call her to come and join me. Sit up. Wait. Settle. Good. Now I found to start with, she faced me. It's not a problem. As long as she's staying stationary, that gave her reassurance. I didn't mind in the least when she came up and sat against me either. Again, for reassurance made paddling incredibly difficult, but it got her started out. Good girl, well done. We can press her off. Okay, off. Good. Good girl. And on it, and settle. Good girl, well done. Good puppy. And settle. Settle. You can see, as I start adding some more movement, good girl, then she's finding it more reassuring to look at me. So that's fine. Good girl, and settle. Settle. Good. Nice work. Good girl. And settle. Let's get some move. Settle. Okay. So if she's not comfortable, we wait. And settle down. No reward for that behaviour, but obviously we don't ever tell them off because we don't want them to associate anything like this with being told off. So we'll get her settled again and comfortable. Settle. Good girl. Well done. Good. And settle down. That's better. And this is where I did find to start with. She wanted to hug me for reassurance. And that's no problem at all. To be fair, we haven't done this on a stationary board for 2 years. Been a while, and now she's out on water. She's probably wondering what's going on. Settle down. Settle down. Good. Good. make some arm motions. So I'm going to be paddling. And it's all these things. We're just building up. Her acclimatisation. Good girl. Move my arms around. I can wave to people. I can do anything. And it's all good. Well done, puppy. All these things we don't think about. If you suddenly chuck them in literally at the deep end with everything at once, it's a lot to get used to. Now that would be enough of the session. That was her first session, so we'll leave it there. Good girl, Odie. Well done. Off you go then. Good girl, Penelope. Good. Well done. Same thing, at the end of the session, I want my dog off so that I can then concentrate getting off the board. So, dog is quite happy getting on and off the board. Need to introduce the buoyancy aid. Odie had a much stiffer one when she was younger, a very good make, but she found it too stiff. But it did the job, particularly while she was growing. If your dog, if you don't think they're going to like this, if they're food motivated, brilliant, have their dinner ready. With buoyancy aid, put their dinner straight down. If they're toy motivated, have a ball ready. Get the buoyancy on, take it on, and go chuck a ball. So, right, Odie. Good girl. Yeah. Yeah, well done. Good puppy. And again, there's no hurry to it. Good. Good girl. Well done. You'll need to fit it, so that's a good chance to have a play around. Good. So, I'd be happy to put on to Curly comfortably. And then if this was really her first time, we'll give her something to do. Get it. Good girl. So if she's not thinking about buoyancy aid. Good girl. Well done. Good girl. Ready. Go. And I'd start that separately to anything to do with the board, to be honest. Get her used to buoyancy aid, then come back to that. So let's make sure we've got everything ready and everything ready to go on the water. So we've got buoyancy aid on. We've got board ready. Let's give it a go. Right, come here. Sit. Good girl. Wait. I want to get my paddle. Sit up. Good. Good girl. Nice. Wait. I'd be able to get my paddle. Now, I do have a lead on her. It's quite controversial. I don't attach it to anything. I have a lead after she was pulled off the board by a swan. It just gives me that extra length to help her back if needed. The handle on the buoyancy aid is for pulling them back on if needed, but it's not, it's all, sometimes a bit far away. So I do have a lead as well. Good deal. Right, you're ready. On it. Yes. And settle. Good. Well done. Good girl. Good girl. So I have my dog happy in her buoyancy aid, happy to get on the board, happy with movement. Good girl. And settle. Happy with me paddling. If I were going to be getting up and down to stand, she'd also need to be comfortable with that. It's not something I do, but we'll see what she thinks. So, Otie, on place and settle. Doesn't all have to be done at once though. And settle. Good girl. Good girl. Good girl. Good. Good girl. Well done. So she's pretty happy. On the board. Knows what she's up to. I would then go and find a lake or somewhere that you can get on and off really easily. And I actually got in the water myself, took the board to the side, had her come on, stay on it for 20 seconds, 30 seconds, lots of praise, off, play with the ball. I then built that up slowly. I did this at Roadford Lake, which was an ideal spot on a quiet day, and built it up. And by the end of that session, we were doing 10 minutes or so on board. She was still facing with me. She was a little bit uncertain, but she was doing it. Once you've got that in place, build it up slowly. In all honesty, it took her about 8 sessions before I could say she'd relaxed properly. She was on the board because I'd asked her to be, and she wanted to be with me. She wasn't necessarily on the board because that's where she felt really confident and safe being. It took quite a few paddles to get to that stage. So don't worry about it. It'll come. I went away for a week this year, Lake District in Scotland, and paddled every day and decided I needed to change to electric pump. That was another sound to get her to used to, so used it on the car, in the driveway, and again, playing a game, getting her used to that sound. If I'm out on a really long paddle, I'll let her have a break. So after about an hour, I'll pull to the side, let her off onto the bank, another reason for my having a lead on, let her have a wee, and get back on. Know your dog's limitations, keep it short, keep it happy, and I hope that helps. Don't take